Hello everyone, and as you see here, this is my fifth sketchbook, or sketchpad, as it says right here. And I've been drawing in the sketchbook a lot. I'm going to show you guys what I'm drawing in the sketchbook so far. I guess you can say sketchpad or a sketchbook. You can use like pencil, pen, and charcoal. I remember using charcoal in my dry drawing classes once. So I use a lot of charcoal. It's very messy though. I don't like using charcoal a lot. I see here in my first page, this is Talon from Falcon Force. You know, flying and doing the gliding, doing the stoop. I mean, falcons have always fascinated me because of how fast they were. Especially when they do the stoop and they travel at least 215 miles per hour, I think. Or at least 200 miles per hour. And they catch their prey in midair. And it's like very cool and stuff. I say stuff again. It's very cool. But they catch pigeons in midair. And pigeons are no slouch either. They're pretty fast too. And falcons managed to catch them in midair. That's very cool. So I managed to draw a character based on Falcon's Talon Angel and his mate or wife Angel. Here's Mr. Blob, who I try to draw more detail for some reason with the more eyes and stuff, making him more menacing. My Mr. Blob flipbook video is the most viewed video I have on my channel. It's the only channel that I managed to reach 1,000 views. And it's very popular in the UK. People in the UK really like my Mr. Blob flipbook. Here's the Axe Knight character. And would you guys consider this guy a mech? Because I tried to draw mechs lately. And I figured I just already drew mechs in general. From this Axe Knight character. I guess I'm trying to draw more of the more legged mechs that look more like dinosaurs. The more dinosaur-legged mechs. The long legs. It does look weird that way. Yeah, I already drew a mech character and an Axe Knight character. More of a medieval character. Or my character based on medieval character times and stuff. Here is Abby from Karate Bugs. Just chilling. Yeah, Abby from Karate Bugs. I guess she's starting to become the main character of the show. And here's a landscape drawing that I tried to draw. I guess I say this is more of northern states or Canada in general. I know Canada has deer and moose over there, so I tried drawing a deer as well and the trees. It's more of a Canadian landscape with the large mountains and everything. Yep. Here is a saber-toothed cat character that I tried to do, which was an inspiration for the characters in Cat Island Adventures. If you guys who don't know, the sketchbook that I drew Cat Island Adventures is actually this sketchbook. And this is the inspiration for the design for both Hugo and Tiger from Cat Island Adventures. I guess you say this character Campamir in Cat Island Adventures as a separate character on those two, probably in the near future if I eventually start to draw more comics of Cat Island Adventures. Here's Luna the Vampire Bat from Werewolf. A bat lady. Here is a Sword Knight character that I draw a lot in my other sketchbooks. I guess you can say this is a mech too. A mech drawing of a Sword Knight character. Yeah, I'm drawing that a lot. And here's an airplane drawing that were realistic drawings of usually when I try to draw objects like cars and airplanes, they usually premiere good out because it actually looks like it. But when I try to draw realistic animals, it always premieres cartoony because I draw cartoons and stuff. I usually draw cartoons. And my dad really liked his drawing too. Like the airplane drawing. And here's another more traditional drawing of an airplane, a smaller airplane. And here is a messed up drawing of I guess you could say this is Belle from Scrappy Discovery riding an aircraft because she owns the aircraft. I tried to draw her and I kind of messed up a lot. So instead of like I created like multiple times and I just gave up. And this is an iguana, a more realistic iguana drawing. I can see it's aside from the eyes, everything else is realistic aside from the eyes. The eyes are poor cartoony because I usually don't draw realistic eyes and stuff. This is iguana. I see notice the other country that I'm visiting lately is the US Virgin Islands, which is St. Croix, Thomas and John, and the island St. Croix has a lot of iguanas there. So I decided to join iguana while I was down there. Especially ones in my backyard. Here's some robot characters that I like to draw. Robot character right here. Here's CR4 and R2, Rick and Chris. Robot characters. And a whole page full of them. And here is Figgy the Squirrel saying hi to you guys. I guess she's just chilling too. I guess that's the dryer in the background. Here's a Smix dragon. Here's my ugly dragon character I tried to draw. Looks horrible. Yeah, I'm definitely not proud of this one. I do like how this one turned out. This is the Sphinx Dragon. Because the inspiration for this design was on DeviantArt. Because this guy was drawing a Sphinx Dragon on DeviantArt. And it became the inspiration for this dragon design I wanted to draw as well. Here's another dragon character that I'm not proud of. Because the wings look kind of weird. I guess you can say these are robot dragon more because these are rockets. I'm trying to draw more are both organic and metallic or artificial. Yeah, I'm definitely not proud of this one. This kind of looks like the kaiju dragon that I also draw as well. Here is the humpback whale and sperm whale, because I like drawing whales as well. The whales. Here's my I tried to make up for the last for my failed art attempt my few pages earlier of Belle from Scrappy Discovery. And the inspiration for this her character was Samus on Metroid, if you guys didn't know that. I guess I already said that in my other sketchbook videos, but yeah, she's the inspiration from Samus from Metroid. Because I play a lot of Super Metroid. Those Metroidvania games are very fun too. Those Metroidvania games like Castlevania and Cave Story. I guess to say this is the made up for the my other. Let's see, yeah, right here. Well, I messed up trying to draw her hovercraft, so I tried to redraw her with a hovercraft like here. I got a notification. I go away. Notifications. Oh, I see. As you can see here, this is Kyle Adventures. Here's the drafting art for them. My characters Hugo, Mizusaki, Candy, Moon, Duke, and Tiger. I kind of already did a read-through of this in my other videos, so I'm probably not going to bother reading it to you guys. I probably took too much time on this video as well, so I had to save memory on my phone when I decided to read this. And this is a rhinoceros beetle that I kind of messed up a little bit. Yeah. Here is Megan from Scrappy Discovery as well, the mutant girl, as she's liking the BattleBots, because I've been watching a lot of BattleBots lately. BattleBots, it's mostly on Discovery Channel because they don't show those on Discovery Channel anymore for some reason. They don't show reruns of it. And Freevee, I think it was what it was. Freevee, the free streaming app, doesn't have BattleBots either. I wonder what happened to it. It's a very fun show too. People really mechanics be building robots and having them fight each other. It's very fun to watch. Apparently, it's been, this is the 90s. I didn't know that. So, as people like to do in their spare time. And here are some flying characters. A flying squirrel and a flying bat. Or a flying squirrel and a bat character. As you can see here, these characters are probably going to appear in Falcon Force. They're probably going to appear in Falcon Force because I'm going to have exclusively flying characters in Falcon Force. Only flying characters are allowed in Falcon Force. And here is Jack the Dragon from the Flight is Dragon comic that I did as well. Here is an anthropomorphic Harpy Lady character. Harpy Lady character who kind of looks like Angel from Falcon Force. More of a combination between an Anthro bird and a Harpy Lady. And here's an elf lady, because I like to draw mythical creatures as well. And an elf lady with a cute dress. Here's a more improved version of the Rhinoceros Beetle drawing that I did a drawing video. I did a video of. I probably left a link in the description for that. You guys want to see that too? I enjoyed this. Here is Brutus from Karate Bugs, who's also an Rhinoceros Beetle. Here is Pat the Pummeler, who's a wrestler character that I used to do animations of. Well, I usually don't do them anymore. I think it's my last YouTube channel. Here is an old man character that I tried to draw. Old man with the big mustache. I did try to draw him with a beard, but the beard never looked right, so I erased it anyway, so. You guys think it's like the old version of Super Mario? When Super Mario was an old man? The beard and everything? Oh, the mustache and everything. Nah. Looks look more... What does he look like? He looks like something. He looks familiar to some character, but I don't remember which character it was. I just wanted a jeweled old man, and just how it turned out. Here's a moth lady, beautiful wings and stuff. Moth lady. I guess it's like she can make appearance in Karate Bugs. Moth lady. Here's Candy from Kyle the Adventures as well. And here's the kaiju from Cult and his kaiju. I guess you say this is more of a turtle kaiju, or kind of, let me scratch that. It's more of a, like a dinosaur kaiju. Kind of looks more like an ankylosaurus. Here's a monster drawing character that I draw a lot too. Monster character. And here are some, I'll consider Fakemon that I wanted to draw. Fakemon, you know, different types of Pokemon, and the Pokemon that are made by the fans. If I were to get these Fakemon typings, it'll probably be, this will be Fire Fairy, this will be Steel Ground, Dragon Flying, Normal type, and Fighting Flying type. Yeah, this will be typings of the characters. If I'm able to give them typings, because these are more Fakemon characters. As you can see here, this is Scrappy Discovery 5, where I lost motivation to finish. I mean, I did manage to put To Be Continued at the end of the comic, because this comic was going too on for too long, with 15 pages for exactly, which is twice the length of most of my comics. I'm not going to leave any spoilers for this comic, but this is the origin story of Megan that I wanted to make up before she got mutated. And it was going on for too long, and I kind of lost motivation to finish it. And sometimes I'll go on for months while drawing in this Sketchpad or Sketchbook. I'll go for 2 months while drawing in this book because of it. And since I wanted to draw more in this Sketchbook, I just left it off a cliffhanger right here. Yeah. Here's a mech drawing. I don't know why I think most mechs look like this, or the weird legs and everything. Why do they draw mechs with weird legs anyway? If you guys saw pictures of robots they've been making up lately, with the weird legs and everything, they'll be running, it looks kind of creepy. It looks unsettling to me. I don't know why. It looks weird. I don't know why people will be making robots with weird legs, but it became an inspiration for this mech design. Here's a cow lady. that cute cow lady that I like to draw. Info lady. Info cow lady. Or a monitor lady. Here's I guess you say like a compilation of all my dragon characters. At least the dragon characters that have like a that mostly draw more pictures of. The land dragon, the normal dragon, well the flying dragon, the land dragon, Drake the dragon, the fairy dragon, the shark dragon, Mini the dragon, the snake dragon snake, the wyvern dragon, and the dragon kaiju. These are dragons that I usually like to draw most of the times. So I do draw like a lot of dragons, but I usually don't remember all their designs. So these are the dragons that I remember, at least. At least the ones that I keep my memory lit. Here's a monkey character I like to draw a lot too. I think I did a drawing video of this character as well. I'm not sure. I think I switched out my my YouTube playlist to see if I drew this character in one of my how to draw videos and see. If I did draw it, I'm probably gonna leave a link in the description for it. And here's Loon the Vampire Bat. I draw a lot too. From Werewolf. This Luna again. And here is a Stichorhynchosaurus. I think that's how you pronounce it. It's a type of Triceratops. Yeah, it's a very cool design as well. And here's an Ichthyosaur that had convergent evolution with dolphins. They look similar to dolphins, but they're actually marine reptiles, which is actually fascinating to me as well. And there are some like interesting ichthyosaurs. There are even ichthyosaurs that are as large as blue whales that I did that Science of Science discovered now. And that's very interesting as well. They grew that large, which I'm probably going to draw in the future as well. I'm going to draw more ichthyosaurs, more bosasaurs, maybe more plesiosaurs. Actually, I like to draw dinosaurs. And that's how I've been drawing this sketchbook so far. So these are empty pages. Yeah, but this is how I've been drawing my sketchpad or this sketchbook so far. Yep, and this is my sketchpad. Yeah, make sure to like, comment, subscribe if you guys like to see more. And that's it.